Wow, 138 watts. So you've got over 9 amps up in the top left corner and 15 volts. That is a considerable difference.
Welcome back to the Amusing Greg. A lot of travellers start off with a cheap solar blanket, but you quickly discover you need something better unless you're an occasional weekender. So in this video, I'm going to compare 4 popular solar blankets in the $500 to $850 range while I embark on a 25,000 kilometre road trip around Australia. Now in previous videos, you guys had asked me to review the 200W Hard Korr blanket and the 200W iTechWorld blanket. But while shopping for these, I also came across the 200W companion blanket, which had a few features I really liked. I bought these 3 blankets with my own money in January 2023. Shortly after this, Redarc loaned me their 160W blanket to review, which was a good opportunity to see what they'd improved on from their older 150W version, which I reviewed in 2021, apart from this new one being half the price. There'll also be a brief appearance of iTechWorld's 300W solar blanket, but most of that will be in a separate video. Now, given we're going into a lot of detail on 4 different blankets today and touching on a 5th, this is going to be a long video, so I'm going to break it up into 4 different parts. If you're interested in buying any of these blankets, every section will be important, but if you're just browsing, you may like to skip sections which aren't as relevant to you. In the rest of part 1, we'll do an unboxing and an overview of each of the 4 blankets. In part 2, we'll hit the road and test how all the different accessories work, like cables and regulators. Part 3 is where we get deep into the testing. We're still on the road here and we'll find out what each blanket's like to live with day to day, any quirks or issues, how they stand up to 3 months of regular use, and most importantly, how much power they all put out. Finally, in part 4, we'll pull all that data together, compare the strengths and weaknesses of each product, and pick a winner. When I bought these in January 2023, street prices ranged from $579 for the Hard Korr up to $850 for the Redarc. I got a $50 discount on the Hard Korr because I bought the companion blanket at the same time, but I paid $30 extra on the iTechWorld for express shipping, so it arrived in time before we started our travels. I paid nothing for the Redarc as it's just on loan. The Hard Korr blanket comes in a nice dark glossy cardboard box. When I got the blanket out of the box, my first impression was that it was very big and heavy.
Big one.
It's nearly 3/4 of a metre wide and weighs in at a considerable 11.6 kilos. Probably because of its weight, the Hard Korr helpfully comes with a shoulder strap. At the front is a simply massive accessory pouch. Dig around deep enough and you'll eventually unearth a 6 metre Anderson plug to Anderson plug cable, an Anderson to alligator clips adapter for connecting onto a battery, a 15 amp PWM regulator, some stainless steel tent pegs to peg the blanket in place, and finally some paperwork. Now what you're seeing here is the Hard Korr's outer storage bag. Once you unzip the storage bag, you find the blanket itself isn't quite as big and bulky as it first appeared. The predominantly deep black colour scheme is pretty typical, but personally I find the aesthetics a bit boring compared to some others in this mix. The accessory pouch not being attached to the blanket itself makes it slightly easier to set up and protects the blanket in storage, but if you leave the storage bag behind, you also leave all your accessories behind. It's not right or wrong, it's just a difference. Now the outer body of the Hard Korr is a woven canvas which looks similar to many others. This one's made from something called 1680 denier ballistic nylon canvas. Now there's 2 terms to unpack here. The term ballistic nylon sounds pretty impressive, but sadly it's not bulletproof in any way. This material had a military origin, but these days it's just a fancy name for any nylon woven in a basket weave pattern like this, so it would apply to many other solar blankets on the market. The term denier refers to the weight in grams of 9 kilometres of yarn. The thicker the yarn, the more it weighs, so the denier rating is a simple way of comparing strength of the same type of yarn. But it has to be the same type of yarn to indicate comparative strengths. For example, 100 denier silk obviously isn't going to be as strong as 100 denier steel cable. The common materials for canvas in order of strength are nylon, polyester and cotton. The Hard Korr uses nylon, so it should hold up very well. If you want more information about this sort of material strength testing, check out the article and video linked in the description. The Hard Korr blankets held closed with a long, wide piece of Velcro. Once you've undone the Velcro, you straight away see the Anderson plug which you connect the power into. Most other blankets hide the connector away somewhere like inside the accessory pouch, but I actually like having it right there ready to plug in. It's more convenient. The blanket then unfolds into a 4x1 array, that is, 4 panels lined up in one single row. Behind each panel is a folding leg held in place with Velcro, and each leg is tethered in place with a fixed strip of material to stop them opening too far. They're similar to what I first saw on the AllSpark panel I reviewed in 2022. When you fold a solar blanket up, the panel surfaces rub against each other, which means any dirt or grit on the panels has the potential to scratch the surface. All the blankets in this review have a dimpled surface made from a very tough plastic called ETFE, and this is really good for two reasons. Firstly, a dimpled surface means that when you fold the blanket up, only a very small portion of the surfaces actually touch each other and are susceptible to this sort of damage. But secondly, ETFE is a much tougher surface material than the softer PET coating used on cheaper blankets. King's blankets, for example, use a flat PET panel, and I've covered in my previous reviews how quickly that coating scuffs off in the real world. I don't expect any such problems with the dimpled ETFE surfaces on these panels, but we'll see how they hold up in real testing. Hard Korr calls this surface CROCSKIN, others have got their other fancy name for it. Folding up the Hard Korr is easy. Let the legs fold in, lay the blanket flat on its back, and then just fold one panel over the next until they're all folded up, and push down the Velcro strip to close it. On top of the Hard Korr is a wide rubber handle with cutouts here and there to make it flexible. It's comfortable enough, but like most flexible handles, you tend to get more weight pushing on the edges of your fingers rather than it being spread evenly across your whole hand. But it's not a big deal. The Hard Korr comes with a 3-year warranty, which is above average for up-end blankets. It has an IP64 environmental rating, which means it can be left out in the rain, and it's made in China. The companion comes in a dark box with a matte laminate rather than a gloss finish, but the blanket itself is picked out in gloss. I think this combination works very well and it looks very classy. Inside the box there is a poly bag to protect the blanket from scuffing. The blanket has a dark grey and blue colour scheme, and the surface material has a matte type of finish a bit like the box did. Again, this gives it a premium feel, and it was one of the things which attracted me to the companion when I first saw it in store at Snowy's. The companion blanket's just over 50cm in each direction, and it weighs 10.4 kilograms. It's a more standard size solar blanket, if you like, and sitting next to the Hard Korr in store, the companion was certainly a more suitable size for what I wanted. On the front of the companion blanket is the accessory pouch. It's not as cavernous as the Hard Korr's, which could almost act as a small tent, but it's quite adequate for what it needs to contain. Inside, you'll find another poly bag with all the accessories very neatly packed together. This extra packaging may not be the best for the environment, but it certainly continued to give an upmarket impression during unpacking, much like unboxing an expensive mobile phone. Inside the accessory pouch you'll find a 5m Anderson plug lead, an Anderson to alligator clips cable for connecting directly to a battery, a PWM solar regulator, and the power output lead. There's also a good instruction manual which ships in the outer poly bag. The body itself is made from 900 denier polyester, which is a thinner and weaker yarn than the Hard Korr's 1680 denier nylon. I like the matte appearance, though it feels a bit coarser and scratchier than the smoother and slipperier nylon on the Hard Korr. The companion's held closed with a single strip of grey material and a press stud, which looks nice and does the job. It then unfolds into a 5x1 array with legs. Now, the fact it's got 5 smaller panels rather than 4 larger ones is the reason it's able to have a smaller and a more manageable footprint than the Hard Korr while still having the same power rating. Now here's where we come to the next feature I loved about this product when I saw it, and this really was the clincher that made me buy it. The legs fold out like the others, but you can adjust the angle of the legs to make sure it's always getting the optimum sun angle. The tethering strap on each leg is attached to the leg with Velcro, so you can pull the tether strap off and move it all the way up and down the back of the leg, meaning you can adjust its angle anywhere between a claimed 30 up to 45 degrees. Bluetti uses a similar idea on their PV200, but they have press studs in certain spots rather than a continuous strip of Velcro. This really is a great extension of the idea of legs on solar blankets. How much of a benefit this provides will depend where in the world you're going to use it, but we'll discuss that when we come to the field tests. The final little attention to detail feature I noticed in store is that the amount of material between each panel varies depending on how many other panels it has to wrap around when it folds up. The very end panel only has a small strip of material between it and its neighbour, as those two fold right together, but as you work along the hinge gets wider and wider to compensate for the greater number of panels it needs to fit around. This results in all the panels being perfectly aligned when you come to fold it up. Hard Korr uses a wide hinge everywhere, and this results in the material being a little bit bunched up at the shorter end when not as much width is needed. The surface of the panel is dimpled ETFE again, although it has a matte finish rather than a glossy one, which may help light absorption slightly. It should be strong and scuff resistant like the others. It doesn't have a fancy name, but I'm pretty sure it should work just as well without one. Folding the companion up isn't quite as intuitive as the Hard Korr. You lay it flat again, then fold one panel in from the end with the accessory pouch, two panels from the other end, and then fold the two sections together. Clip it off together, and you're done. It's not quite as simple as just going from one end to the other, but it's also not as hard as it sounds. Once it's folded up, the companion has two fabric handles with a piece of textured rubber bonded around it. They're adequate, without being special in any way. In fact, they're the same as what's in my Austrail camping chair. They flex just like the Hard Korr one did, but they're probably slightly less comfortable than the Hard Korrs. The companion comes with a 2-year warranty, which is standard for more expensive blankets. The companion has no IP environmental rating, which means it can't be left out in the rain, and it's made in China. The iTechWorld comes in a gloss white cardboard box with nice printing and a plastic carry handle attached, which is a small but nice feature over the others. Inside the box you'll find the only solar blanket on the market wearing its own high-vis jacket. Your opinion may vary, but I quite like the bright orange with white trim, and it will certainly stand out from the sea of black and silver blankets in the campsite. Overall, the blanket looks neat and premium. On its front is an accessory pouch, similarly sized to the companion's. You'll find there a 5-meter Anderson plug cable, an Anderson to Alligator Clips cable, a PWM solar regulator with the same design as the companion and the old King's regulators, and the power output lead. There's also an instruction manual for the blanket and a separate one for the regulator. The iTechWorld is the same height as the companion, but it's about 8 centimeters longer. However, it's lighter than the others so far at only 9 kilos, including all the accessories. The body of the iTechWorld blanket is made from 600 denier ballistic nylon, so the same stuff as the Hard Korr, but from a thinner yarn. Now, don't imagine for a minute you could pick the difference just by looking at them. What you're seeing here is the weaving pattern, but the individual fibres are fractions of a millimetre thick. You can see here that the Hard Korr's black fibres look a bit thicker than the orange iTechWorld ones, but even all those are barely 1/100th of a millimetre thick, which is several times thinner than the human hair. So we're dealing with exceptionally thin yarn either way. The iTechWorld blanket is held together with two very nice looking clips. It then unfolds into a 4x1 array, just like the Hard Korr, and the back of each panel has a fold-out leg. Most blankets with legs have a solid strip of material which tethers the bottom of the leg in place. However, the legs on the iTechWorld have an elastic arrangement which allows them to be pulled back a bit to adjust the angle of the blanket a touch. Now, I only discovered this after a few weeks of use, and if this is the reason it has elastic leg supports, I'm astonished that iTechWorld doesn't advertise this as a feature anywhere. Considering their marketing is so heavy in other areas I don't feel really matter too much, overlooking something like this that certainly makes a difference to the user is a surprising miss. The only downsides I can see compared to the companion are the reduced range of adjustment, and also that over time the elastic will probably lose its elasticity. The surface of the panel has the same type of dimpled ETFE as the others. iTechWorld calls this raptor skin. Folding up the iTechWorld is very easy. Just fold the four panels one over the other and clip them together. On top of the blanket is a hard textured plastic handle which is very comfortable in the hand. The reason for this is that because it's a solid hard handle, it holds its shape under load, which means that the weight gets evenly spread across your hands rather than pressing down harder on the edge of your fingers like what happens with flexible handles. At 9 kilos, it's not that heavy to move around, and its size is compact enough for most storage spaces. Surprisingly, the iTechWorld blanket only comes with a 1-year warranty, which is below average for more expensive blankets like these. The iTechWorld has an IP64 rating, which means it can be left out in the rain, and it's made in Hong Kong. And last we come to the Redarc, which is only a 160W unit versus 200W for the other three. As I said earlier, this is just on loan from Redarc, so I could see what that improved from the 150W unit I covered a couple of years ago. The Redarc comes in a nice gloss red cardboard box with the specs on the back. Inside the box you have the blanket, which comes in a thin black storage bag along with the instructions. Pull the blanket out of the bag and it's a very small, light and compact unit. It's only a bit longer than the 30cm ruler in each direction and it weighs just under 5kg. Now you may well say, well of course it's smaller, it's lower power than the others, but its size and weight advantage is a lot more than the 20% difference in power rating. One reason for this is because there's no accessories bundled with the Redarc, so if you want those, they're an extra cost. Because of that, there's also no accessory pouch on the Redarc. The outer storage bag is simply that, a simple sleeve with a pull tie at the top. There's not even a handle on it. The body of the Redarc is made from rubber impregnated polyester yarn like their old model, and at the time of producing this video, Redarc hadn't confirmed the denier rating of the polyester. The back surface of the blanket feels very nice. It's smooth and soft, almost a bit like suede. I did note in my previous Redarc review last time that the rubber started to show signs of stress after a few months of use. So this is how one looks when it's brand new, and it'll be interesting to see what it's like after a few months of use. As with their old model, the Redarc blanket is held together by this material strap which wraps around the blanket and then stays closed with a strip of Velcro. Opening this reveals the Anderson plug connector, and for what it's worth, the Redarc is the only blanket in this lot which uses genuine Anderson branded connectors. Whether or not that matters is another question, but it does suggest Redarc is choosing high quality components for their products. Setting up the blanket is fairly simple, so long as you start with it on the ground. Undo the Velcro strap, and then unfold the blanket straight out and unfold one strip of panels. This leaves you with a 4x2 array. Note that the Redarc blanket has got no legs to prop it up. You'll need to lay it over something like a car windscreen to get angled at the sun, or hang up from the hanging hooks, but that's one of the trade-offs you get with such a small and light blanket. The surface of the Redarc panels have a dimpled ETFE coating. Again, this is the same coating I looked at in 2021, which performed flawlessly over several months. To pack up the Redarc, you fold it lengthways, then concertina the four surfaces up, wrap the strap around and Velcro the strap together. There's no carry handle on the Redarc, but the easiest way to carry is with the hand underneath, as though you're carrying a large book. Being under 5 kilos, it's not difficult at all to carry around. Now, I got this totally wrong in my last Redarc blanket review. I was always trying to grip it from above like other blankets with handles, which was very difficult, and I didn't even think to try carrying it like this until somebody pointed out to me in the comments. Dunart100, thanks very much for setting me straight. The Redarc blanket comes with a 2-year warranty, which is average. The Redarc has no IP environmental rating, which means it can't be left out in the rain, and it's made in China. Now, I'll award 2 scores at this point for things which aren't potentially going to change over time. In all these scores, lower is better, that is, 1 is first place. The appearance of the product box and the product themselves are both very subjective, but here's how I've scored them, but you make your own decision. Here's a summary of the specs I've just covered about each blanket. Pause the video here if you want to take this in a bit more. So now we know how they present out of the box, let's hit the road and see how they stand up to a few months of real-world use as we travel through parts of eastern Australia. They'll be used at lower latitudes, high latitudes, summer, winter, full sun and overcast conditions, and we'll discover what worked well, any gremlins to look out for, and perhaps the most important point of how much power can you expect from them in the real world rather than just in lab tests. Now, this test isn't just about power, that's important, but there are lots of other little factors which might ultimately decide which blanket's best for you. Now, I was only able to compare all 4 blankets between January and April 2023 because the iTechWorld blanket was returned as faulty, so after that I only had the other 3 blankets to work on. I'll go into all the reasons for that under the performance section. But let's head into part 2 now and see how the accessories actually worked.